Hi, it's Grace again. I've been asked how I make very fine hems in linen. There are some tricks, and hopefully I can explain some of them in this video. The first trick is to actually have a really nice fine linen. The linen I'm using is probably the finest that I've ever used. It's like one, it's less than 2 ounces per yard. The second trick is I use wheat starch to keep the hem from unraveling once it's been cut. So the proportions are roughly like 1:7 to 1:10 water to wheat starch. I stir it into warm water and then I heat it up in the microwave for about 30 seconds. I make a little tiny bit at a time, so doing it in the microwave is the best way I've found to do that. I watch it like a hawk because it'll boil over. When it starts boiling over, then you know it's right. You want it to be about the consistency of snot, healthy snot. If I were using this starch on an actual garment, I would have sieved it, sifted out the lumps. But because I'm using this on a proto garment, I am not as concerned. I use a Q-tip to apply the starch. I've used in the past some of my husband's paint brushes. Unfortunately, occasionally they are not washed out as well as I would have liked, and my it was kind of a little disturbing to have my linen turn purple. So I've gone to using Q-tips because I know that they're always clean. Once I have let it dry and ironed it, I can cut the edge off. Usually I pull a thread to have a straight line to cut to, but because this was such a dominant selvage, I was able to just cut to the selvage edge. The starch acts like a fray check, and keeps the edge from unraveling when you're turning your hem. So basically putting the linen on a hard surface, the starch should also make it so that you can turn it just by finger pressing. I use my fingernail and make the crease more permanent, and then whenever it gets too, goes too far, I can pull it back with my fingernail. The other trick is if you kind of get it going and you can get a handle on it. If you tension the top or the outermost edge, it helps with getting a nice fine turn. I don't know if you can see what I'm doing there. I'm pulling on that outer edge with my right hand, and then with my left hand, I'm walking up the turn. And then I just basically go the other way and turn it a second time. I'm turning it up to the holes made by the four-sided stitch on the P-hole hem stitch, because I'm going to be using those holes to sew through to do my hem. You don't want to go over top of the holes because the holes are the decorative element. So anytime it gets too close, I can pull it back with my fingernails a little bit and remake the crease. I'm just creasing this with my fingernails at this point. So here I'm pulling it back a little bit because it went too far. So at this point, I'm just going to go take it and iron it to set the hem. Now here, I'm essentially just going through the stitch backwards like a back stitch, through the hole from the four-sided stitch on the edge of the p-hole hem stitch. And then I'm taking a little stitch through my hem. It's really easy if you've already got the p-hole hem stitch in place. If you don't have the p-hole hem stitch in place, you would pull a thread to guide your hem up to, and then you would go through where you've drawn the thread out and go and take three or four ground threads with each stitch, and then go through your hem with your next stitch. And then you'd go back up, go through three or, backwards, take up three or four threads, and then go through your hem. I hope that I have given you some additional tips to make your hems as fine as possible. Good luck. Happy stitching.